What's up, YouTubers? So before we get started with this video on GetUp, they're going to be talking about Deshaun Watson and how his opinion was disregarded by the coaching staff regarding a new head coach. So let's see what they have to say about that.
Deshaun Watson, really unhappy with the way that events unfolded in Houston last week. And people could say, oh, it's an overreaction, it's early. But I was told that if his anger level was a quote-unquote 2 last year after they traded DeAndre Hopkins away, his anger level now is at a 10, and it's at a 10.
That's a problem.
Because the Texans went to him for advice and recommendations on what to do going forward. He gave some feedback that was basically ignored during the process, and it was ignored in favor of bringing in someone else from New England after they've had a history of people in New England, leaving Deshaun Watson very unhappy. He's been on vacation. He hasn't spoken to the team. My understanding is that this is going to be a long-term deal, that he may want to be traded. He may opt to withhold his services. And again, it's early in the offseason, but this bears watching, Greeny.
Yes.
This doesn't make any sense. I don't know why the Houston Texans would do that. First, to get rid of DeAndre Hopkins, which is huge because he's one of the best wide receivers in the league. And he showed that as soon as they got rid of him. And now they're disregarding Deshaun Watson's opinion on getting a new head coach and new coaching staff. That just doesn't make any type of sense right there. That completely shows that they don't care anything about Deshaun Watson or what he thinks or what he wants. And it's really dumb because he's their best player. It doesn't make any type of sense. If I was Deshaun Watson, I'm out of there because you can't trust anything the Houston Texans have to say.
Kazario is the man they've hired to be their general manager at this point, and there is a head coaching vacancy there. Fascinating. Rex, you were there on Sunday Countdown yesterday, obviously. What is your big picture take right now on Deshaun?
Yeah, I just thought it was crazy. I mean, number one, I get it. If you bought a franchise, then you can hire whoever the heck you want. I get that. But why would you go to this young man and say, listen, I want your input, and then just and totally disregard it?
Mm-hmm.
So if you're going to say that he's going to be part of the process, then allow him to be part of the process. And so to me, it was just it's a bad look either way. And I mean, could you imagine if you trade Deshaun Watson? This is one of the best quarterbacks in the league, and he's young. And oh my God, you're going to trade him? Like, that blows me away. It absolutely blows me away. But you might not have a choice. I mean, if you never had to bring him in. That's what I don't understand. He never asked you to bring him in to make decisions.
Right.
Why the hell do you treat? You tell him you're going to listen to him, and then all of a sudden you dismiss it. I don't know.
Go ahead, Danny.
I don't either. And it's so stupid. I don't understand what the problem is. I mean, like I said, I can't talk about DeAndre Hopkins enough of them letting him go. And him and, you know, Deshaun Watson were, you know, a perfect duo in the league and could have been a perfect duo for years to come. But they let go DeAndre Hopkins, and now they're playing games with Deshaun Watson. This doesn't make any type of sense at all. And, you know, I don't even know what to think of it. I really don't. You know, and Deshaun Watson's got to be super PO too. That's disheartening, very disheartening, and make you want to leave.
I think they're going to have to trade him because I don't think he trusts anybody in their organization. He's a top 5 quarterback you can win multiple Super Bowls with. Now, the question isn't who should call. The question is who shouldn't call, because there's only 7 teams in the NFL that shouldn't call: Seattle, Tampa Bay, Green Bay, Buffalo, Baltimore, Kansas City, and the Chargers. Those are the only teams in the NFL that I could sit there and tell you justifiably don't call. The 24 other, they need to call Houston and figure out what's it going to take. What is it going to take? Because every one of those other 24 teams should sit there and go, we can absolutely upgrade. It's worth it, whatever they want. I don't care if it's 4 first-round picks. It is worth it to go get him.
I agree. You do whatever you can to get Deshaun Watson. He said give up 4 first-round picks. I would definitely agree. Deshaun Watson is a franchise quarterback that will be with your team for a long time. It could definitely get you to a Super Bowl and win a Super Bowl, which he probably will by the time his career is over.
Multiple Super Bowls you can win with Deshaun Watson.
Oh, heck yes. Shefty, he has a no-trade clause, yes?
Yeah, well, it's his word on that no-trade clause, Greeny. In other words, the Jacksonville Jaguars could say tomorrow, I'm trading Deshaun Watson to, you come up with the team, the Philadelphia Eagles. And Deshaun Watson could say, I don't want to go to Philadelphia. I want to go to Miami. He dictates the no trade clause. They cannot trade him without his consent, and therefore he is in control of a trade should a trade arise.